Hello everyone, welcome to our channel DexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai and I am starting a series wherein I'll be explaining you what is time series analysis and what are its various keywords and important concept which you should know when you are entering into the world of data analytics. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. So when I talk about time series analysis, what I basically mean is observing a Y data, say this Y is prices. Observing this Y data over a period of time so that you have a graph with dates on the x-axis and the price on the y-axis, and how this data is or how this price is moving over time, you look at that. Now this time series analysis can be of two types. Number one, univariate. Number two, multivariate. So when we talk about univariate analysis, what does it mean is that when we have a single sequence of data observed over a period of time, then in that case it is called univariate time series analysis. Now when I talk about multivariate time series analysis, it basically means when we have several set of data for the same sequence of time, we have several set of data observed over time, in that case it is called multivariate time series analysis. Now the data which is used in a time series analysis, like you have a Y variable and you have 3, 10, 15, 19, which are nothing but prices. The value of each data is random here, okay, and that is why it is a random variable, and a collection of random variables ordered in a time is called random or stochastic process. So you have a collection of this data and this is with a random values, that is called a stochastic process. Now these stochastic processes can be of again two types. Number one is stationary. Number two, non-stationary. Now let me just give you an example of what stationary and non-stationary data looks like. Here you go. You have a stationary data, a graph of stationary data here. So basically what it means is that suppose that you have a Y data which you want to plot over a period of time. Here we have dates, here we have price. This data has a trend line, which is almost same at each level or slightly increasing. So what happens is that a stationary data is, or a stationary stochastic process is where your mean and your variance is constant over time. So the mean value does not change and the variance, the way the data is distributed over time, also does not change. So we have a graph like this. So this makes suppose that we have a fixed pattern. We know that there is a constant mean and we know that the data is distributed in a particular manner, and that manner is constant. So the data distribution like this. Suppose the way data is moving is constant. Okay, so in that case what happens is that that you are easily able to predict what the pattern is. So it makes it easier for the forecasting process. Suppose that you know what the pattern is and you know the data distribution, the way the data is distributing throughout. So you will be easily able to make out the pattern, and then you'll be able to predict the value of what should be the value on the date 21/14. With the help of this pattern, it makes it easy because everything is constant, so the prediction is easy. Now, when it comes to non-stationary process, that basically means that the mean and the variance, or you can say the moment of probability distribution, including the mean, variance, covariance and all that, are all, you know, are not constant and they are changing. So you see the graph, the way it is moving. So for it is downward sloping, then it's upward sloping, and so there is no pattern. You cannot define a pattern to predict a value here. So suppose that this is the value here and this is the value here, this is the value here, and so on and so forth, and we have these kind of values here. Okay, so there is no fixed pattern. If we go ahead and look at the previous graph, that is this one, that is the stationary process, we see that the data is moving upwards and then downwards and then again upwards and again downwards. So here we can see that there is a pattern, but in this particular graph we cannot see the pattern. In that case, the prediction or the forecasting of suppose 20, 01, 13, 14 becomes quite impossible, because you don't have a function that recognizes this kind of a line. If you remember in when I posted my linear regression video, if you haven't watched that particular video, please go ahead and watch that. A lot of concepts have been drawn from that video here, that is mean, variance. I've explained everything there. So if you haven't watched those videos, please click on the I button on the top right hand side corner of your screen and you will be directed to those videos. Go ahead, watch those videos and then come back to this. Then that this particular video will make more sense. So yeah, after a lot of blabbering and self-promotion, let's get back to this part. So that's that. So this is non-stationary process, stochastic process. Now, non-stationary stochastic process can further be explained with a term called or the theory that is random walk models. Basically, the random walk model is used in particular with reference to stock market prices, where it is assumed that one value of Y is independent of the other value. So iska aur iska aapas mein koi lena dena nahi hai, and they are all independent from each other, right? So they technically are random values which are independent. So what happens is that we have two kind of random walk methods. One is random walk with drift, and the other is random walk without a drift. So what happens is that in a non-stationary process where there is no pattern, data is moving the way it wants to. So in that case, suppose that if we give it a property, even if the non-stationary data is given a property, in that property terms, they can be divided into two parts, and the concept or the theory is random walk, where each data is independent of each other. Okay, so the concept of random walk with the drift basically means that whatever the value of Y is to be predicted for a time period T, that depends or is equal to a constant value which is pushing this value from this value to this value. Okay, a constant that is pushing this value to this value, plus, since we are talking about the past data, plus the y minus t, that is the previous time's data, plus an error term. That is the difference between this value and this value. So if you want to predict yt, the concept of feather drift means that there is a constant that is pushing this graph either upwards or downwards, depending upon what value this has, either negative or positive, plus the past value. So what we are trying to do here is we are trying to predict this value, which basically depends on this value and a constant value that say is 0.5, and the error term which is moving throughout. If you don't know what error is, again you have to go ahead and watch that linear regression video. I have explained there what error is all about. But here what I am going to say is that error, little bit of explanation is that the error is nothing but the difference between the observed value and the predicted value. Okay, so this is the error at time t. Now this random walk with a drift, can this constant term, depending upon that constant term is negative or positive, either the data will be pushed upwards or downwards, so the graph will be upwards or downward sloping in that regard. And then same will be done for t plus 1, t plus 2, t plus 3 year, time as well. Now the next is random walk without a drift. So when I say random walk without a drift, it basically means that if I have to predict this value, so what happens is my past value is also included in that. I need my past value and plus a random shock value. Random shock value. This is nothing. So this is random shock. So the equation goes yt equals to yt minus 1 plus et, which is a shock value here. That is the error term. So there is some random value which is causing this change in the data over a period of time, and that is because of the previous data plus the change in between this value. So if we recognize the change that the data is pushing towards to get this value, we'll be able to predict our yt values here. In this scenario, what happens is, suppose that we want to predict a data that is y1. So for that, and the time period is t1. Okay, so for that we need y0, that is the previous year's data, plus the error term, and for time period 2 equals to 2, we will be predicting y2. So it will be y0 plus error of this time period. So let's give it a value 1 and then give it a value 2 here, which is equals to y0 plus e1 plus e2. So the errors are causing the changes in the original value here. Okay, in that case, the mean, if we take out the overall data, the mean value will be a constant, but the variance will change over time. able to find out the long-term mean in this case, but the distribution, the variance is indefinitely changing or increasing over time. So that's it for this video. I hope you got to learn something about time series analysis. In my next video, I will be talking about how to predict data on the basis of moving average, and we'll be also further discussing about the concepts like ARIMA, ARAMA, AR and VR. So please follow us. If you haven't already, please click on the bell icon, because you will get a notification when I post my video regarding this time series series. If you want to learn from us, or if you want to know about us, you can go ahead and go to the website www.textlabanalytics.com, and or you can call us on these numbers on your screen. You can also WhatsApp us or mail us at hello@textlabanalytics.com. We are currently placed in Gurgaon. Please like this video if you liked it. Bye bye. Take care.